All right. Ooh, 20 MS. I like that, Keizu. I like that a lot. All right. All right, I'm done talking. Let's play some Melee. Homer's the homie. Homer's the homie. Please beat my Melee controller plugged in. Acid Rapture, all the Melee subs. No, wait, did we hit 50? Okay. If we don't hit 75 subs by the end of this Melee session, I'm not playing Melee again this week. You guys have like 2 hours though. I'm no pressure. No pressure. Okay, I gotta. Okay. You guys talk amongst yourself. I had to get good at Melee real quick. I can't talk and get good. I don't have autopilot right now. You guys talk amongst yourselves. I'll be back in 15 minutes. Crazy plays so whack. That's why I love playing him, dude. I've always thought something. Me and Joey make the joke all the time. It's very controversial. I think Keizu has better combos than Armada. Keizu hits like a fucking truck, dude. Just knowing that Armada would be so mad about it makes it so funny, too. Give Keizu Armada's neutral? Oh my god. We'll see who the real goat is, dude. Oh my lord. Because we're about to see some shit. Purified? What is it? Just tell me. Also, thanks for the $77 that I didn't acknowledge. I zeroed you, my bad. Shout out to everybody who subbed yesterday. I didn't mean to zero you guys. Armada can't take a joke. It's hard to joke with Armada sometimes. He, like, doesn't see jokes. But, I mean, you know, he's from, like, when I called him a virgin that one time. Like, it's so obviously a joke. Armada doesn't get it. I guess the language bullshit. So, it's not like I blame him. Can't agree at being in his house. Yeah, it's hard to joke with Adam. And, like, he has a good sense of humor. I guess you just have to joke with him. You can't joke with him in American. He doesn't see American jokes for whatever reason. I love Adam, but it's tricky. It's obvious. You can't, like, sarcastically joke with him. Or, like, say, like, if I said something, like, it has to be so obvious or, like, he doesn't read it. But, like I said, that's a language thing, I think, so it's not like it's his fault. I'll bet you a shotgun? Wait, why are you coming over tonight? It's so random. Did we say that last night? What happened? I was just saying you should come over, and then you're like, I'll come over. Winner takes a shotgun. No, I don't want to drink. Joe, you're part of the problem. I took an alcoholic test yesterday, and it said it's your fault. Why did I nuke yesterday's VOD? I don't know. That might be the problem. You said fuck the staff? Oh. But they can't ban me for saying fuck the staff. Like, isn't there freedom of speech? Can I just, you know, say fuck the staff? That's not too bad. They can't ban you for that. They can't, like, if they ban me for saying fuck the staff, that's stupid. We're no better than the Frenchies at this point. They can't ban you for that. You said the guy who banned you was probably ugly? I never said that. I never said that. You said ugly people hate you? Ugly people do hate me! Everyone here is gorgeous. That's why you guys all love me. Except the one guy who's here from fucking Reddit hoping I slip up so he can post something on his little dumb points and get likes or thumbs up or whatever the fuck it works. Fucking virgin. Okay, my good guy, David Bag, you better win Genesis. Why is everyone saying win Genesis? I'm a little bad right now. Fuck, are we getting drunk? No, I just did a whole spiel. This is why people think I'm lying. No. I just did a whole spiel not drinking. No. No. Do you have a tournament plan for 2019? Win. If I go this whole year without winning a tournament again, I'm just quitting. I'm gonna do the zero. Realize I'm past my prime, and I'm just gonna commit to streaming. That's what I'm doing. If I don't win again, I'm doing the zero. Zero isn't past his prime, idiot. Somebody ban that guy. Lol, Reddit user can't take a joke. Lol. Why do people take me? It's so. I hate people. Because people are stupid. It's just like, I feel like, I can't believe people still take me serious. I should never be taken serious. Even if I said, hey, there's a fire. Chances are there isn't a fire. And even if there was, you wouldn't believe me. No, Zane's winning Genesis. My man has not even touched Ultimate. I go on his stream, he was chain grabbing a computer. He did it 20 times in a row and I was like, this is your Genesis champ right here. He was just chain bragging a computer and I was like, I just was like, wow, this guy is winning. This guy wants it. This guy wants it more than us. The shitty thing is HBox doesn't even have to practice, dude. He doesn't even have to practice. And he plays Ultimate the exact same way he plays Melee. It's so dumb. Don't let Zane win. Yeah, I mean, in all actuality, anybody but HBox winning Genesis for us is like a community. Can't just let the number one win the first tournament. That's boring. If Zane dodges Johnny, as long as he dodges the Zane Slayer, Johnny Kim. No Wizzy Melee singles? Wizzy's not doing singles? Why? He's just doing ultimate? What a traitor. His dick's not even that big. Wow. Ooh, I read that ultimate read. Ultimate, watch this. Ooh! You guys remember when Leffen said he's gonna stream Ultimate and then play Melee after to get Ultimate people to play Melee? And then I've seen him play Melee for 10 minutes and then immediately went back to Ultimate. You guys remember that? Or is that just me? Leffen keeps talking about how much he loves Melee. I mean, I don't blame him. Melee is a hard stream game, dude. Unless Genesis puts Ultimate last and not Melee, then we're fucked. Then we're all fucked. Ooh, I'm telling you, Ultimate's making me... I'm telling you. Keep in mind, I haven't played Melee all month, and I'm... My Marv was playing like shit, but... My Fog was playing fucking really good. Play Fox in a little bit. See that little guy's doing. Pretty happy, though. This is already a good first day at Melee. I thought I'd be way worse, but I'm a fucking god. Look at that fucking up air. Look at the big... Look at... Fucking bitch. Ooh, got right in his ass and down... We're winning Genesis because nobody plays Melee anymore. And I like that, but I don't, but I do. How do I feel about Wizzy's keeping Melee Genesis? I am very, very disappointed in him. And you tell that little bitch I'm never peeling an orange for him again. Melee traitor, ultimate loving bitch. I love Wizzy, but how are you not going to enter Melee? How's Mutine going to sub go to enter Melee? I'm pissed. You know what? I'm pissed off with everybody. Let's go, Zane, Ginger, Kalindi. Let's fucking go. I'm pissed at everybody. Somebody ban Mango Pup Beef. He is banned until he subs. Because now he's trying to make me beef with Zero. First of all, fuck Zero. And somebody ban that guy. West Balls does Adderall. Thanks, Vinny. Everybody knows that. Forever Nights, thanks for the 5. Stream last night, me and my friends laughed so much. That's what it's about. I'll get banned. I'll get banned if it means you guys enjoy. I'm always down to die for the joke. I like a commitment to jokes. Did I ever tell you guys about Pocket Chicken? I'm so committed to a joke. I will die with the joke if I have to. Because to me, my jokes are like my babies, dude. I create them. And I gotta make sure they land. Pocket Chicken. TLDR. Mini story TLDR. It started from Pocket Cheesesteak. We were in Philadelphia. I got a cheesesteak. I'll keep it short. TLDR. I carried a cheesesteak in my pocket all night. Why? Because food in your pocket is just objectively funny. Even Reddit kids will say that food in the pocket's funny. Food in the... There's nothing not funny about food in your pocket. There's just... It's just funny. Food in the pocket is a winner. It's just... Like Charlie when he has a bag of spaghetti. That's funny. That's funny. So anyways, I carried a cheesesteak in my pocket all night. And I would take bites of it like every hour. And by the end of the night, it was like rock hard because it was snowing in Philly. And I pulled it out. We were at a bar. And I pulled it out. And I took a bite of it in front of the waitress. Because it was cold, and I'm like, god damn it, I don't really want to, but I have to. It's too funny. It's too funny not to do. So I took a bite of this, like, 10-hour-old cheesesteak. The plastic, like, infused with the bread. You know what? Like, the napkin became part of the bread because it's just been sitting there for so long. You guys know what I mean? So whatever, I took a bite. The bartender started laughing. And you're not even supposed to bring outside food, but I was so committed to my joke. So yeah, that's the origin of food in my pocket. Now, fast forward to... fast forward a few years. Eagles are not Super Bowl champs yet. A little before that, we went to get a Korean fried chicken with Johnny of all people, lol. We get Korean fried chicken and it's fucking a bomb and it's all you can eat. And Lauren decided to get me a little contact high, so I was a little contact high. Also a little drunk, so I was a little contact cross drunk something. So I was a little fucked up. I ate way more chicken than I should have. And I was so fucked up. So whatever, I'm a little fucked up. And the chicken is so good that I can't stop eating it. So me, I put like 3 pieces of chicken in my pocket. In my C9 shorts. So I put the chicken in there. No napkin, because I'm so fucked up. And I'm like, dude, greasy ass chicken in my pocket? That's funny. That's funny. So I put the chicken in my pocket, just raw. And like throughout the night, so we get in the car, we're laughing. I keep like making like shitty dad jokes like, oh, who wants, anybody wants some chicken? And I like pull the chicken out, it's in my hand. Like, anybody want some chicken? You know? Like, anybody? And, you know, everyone's like, no, we don't want your chicken. So now the grease, we get out to go to the movies. And my shorts, like, you get the grease seep through. So now my shorts just have grease stains on them. Okay, I never told you guys pocket chicken. So my shorts have grease stains on them. And now, like, we're getting ready to pay. We're at the movie tickets. Getting tickets for the movie. And finally, I'm like really sad because I realized my chicken joke is over, right? I'm like, well, I got as much mileage I could out of this joke, right? I'm like, I can't do anything else. Whatever. My joke is over. I'm like, it's over. And all of a sudden, from like, it was just like straight from God. Lauren says, Mango, I need the credit card to buy the ticket. And like, like bright lights came down and it was like, oh, and like it came to me. So Lauren puts her hand out and she's looking away, and I just put this old ass chicken in her hand, and everyone just starts dying, and Lauren wants to be mad, but she can't because she's got greasy chicken in her hand. And she was so mad, but it was so funny. She's like, mango, but she like wants to be mad, but she couldn't. It was too funny. So yeah, Lauren just couldn't. It was so funny. But the other time this happened, I was really fucked up at the bowling alley, and TLDR, we're outside, and I have the chicken again in my pocket. Again, I've been holding the chicken for a while. I have the chicken, and I'm chasing Lauren around, and I'm like, all right, Lauren, let's play a game of Destiny. So I'm like, you pick what pocket the chicken's in, and if you pick the one that doesn't have the chicken, I won't. So pick the one that has the chicken, and you don't have to touch it or something. And she picked the right one, and I was so mad that I started chasing her around the parking lot with the chicken. That's funny. That's funny.
Yo, did he just walk up slowly and down smash?
He did.